Hey, welcome back to Java with Jeff today. I'm so glad you're tuning in. I've got my beverage and I've got my Bible. Hope you do too. Push pause, go grab your Bible if you don't, and let's talk about something together. I've been thinking a lot about the Sermon on the Mount, Matthew chapter 5 through 7, where Jesus spoke to the crowds. Maybe he did it at once, maybe he did it over time, we're not quite sure, but Matthew puts it all together in those few chapters. And my wife and I are listening to a teaching, and it's talking about the Sermon on the Mount, and it's just challenging. It is all over again. I've read this section many, many times, and when you go to Israel, you can actually go to the location where they believe this took place, where Jesus taught the Sermon on the Mount. It's a great little slope of a hill off the Sea of Galilee where the acoustics would have been perfect for somebody to speak to thousands of people like Jesus did. And I want to tell you a little background about this section of Scripture. It's challenging the religious leaders of the day, the Pharisees in particular. They were all about outward appearance. If they had social media today, they would be all about getting their follower level up on Snapchat, on Instagram, on Twitter, on X. They would want the number of people following them to go up, and they'd care an awful lot about that because they look so great on the outside, but their hearts were shallow and lost. And this is what Jesus is speaking to in this section of Scripture. I encourage you to read Matthew chapter 5, 6, and 7 all together in one setting. Read it like we do in Israel at this location and be challenged. Because Jesus would say things like this. He'd say in Matthew chapter 5, verse 44, "But I tell you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you." See, it's easy to love those who love you. It's really hard to love those who hate you. It's an amazing challenge that Jesus has, but Jesus isn't going for externals and behaviors. He's going for our hearts. He wants to know what's in your heart. Or he says things like in chapter 6, verse 33, in response to worrying about your life, "But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own." And who of us doesn't worry? We all worry about stuff. We worry about things all the time. And Jesus leans in and says, wait a minute, don't worry about your life. Lean in and seek the kingdom of God first, because that's what this is. This is kingdom values, where we lean in, we follow the King, who is Jesus. And he's setting up a kingdom. And if we want to be in that kingdom, we need to follow these kingdom values that he lays out in Matthew chapter 5, 6, and 7. Or he says things like this in Matthew chapter 7, verse 3. "Why do you look at the speck of sawdust in your brother's eye and pay no attention to the plank in your own eye?" In other words, don't judge somebody else if you haven't worked that out in your own life. Work it out in your own life, in your own heart, in your own thinking first, and then you can go correct your brother. See, all of this is so challenging to me. It cuts right to the heart, which is exactly what Jesus was doing. Jesus was saying, behavior is important, but your heart and where your motivation is and where you're leaning in with him is far more important. So again, I encourage you to go read this section, these three chapters right in a row, and be challenged by it, and then be encouraged that Jesus wants to help us get better leaning into these kingdom values. Hope that's encouraging to you today. I'll see you again soon.